Peg is the orange kitty here. Yeah, I was going to say earlier, I was bitching my...
Redhead has the dark kitty, but why doesn't the dark hair have the redhead kitty? We're like a yin-yang.
No, you missed it. I was bitching my head off, like, wow. Like, you know, angry noises that would scare away a cat. And he just comes running. He's like, okay, what's going on? Jumps right in my lap. Okay!
Got the scare of her life last night. We heard this loud crash. And we all go, and the cat comes running into my room with her tail all poofed out, and she's just like spooked. And we're like, what happened? And we go out, and she hasn't knocked anything over. And we're like, well, she certainly scared the crap out of herself. What happened? And then we realized there was another cat out on the deck. And Bridget likes to look out the back doors onto the deck at night and chase bugs. And unexpectedly, another cat showed up, and she freaked out.
What the fuck is that thing?
Yeah. Why is that in my house?
I thought I was the only one of me. What the shit is this?
She was very, very upset.
Well, it's funny because we're talking about animals, because tonight's show got a lot of animals in it. A lot of animal stuff.
Cute animals doing fun things?
No.
No.
No, no. No, no. Not. Well... I can honestly say none of what happens is the animal's fault, really. Not on them. They didn't start the fire.
So no Hemingway Bear this evening?
No, I miss Hemingway Bear. Because that's a role model right there.
It was a simpler time, Hemingway Bear.
Hemingway Bear and the alcoholic pig, you know.
Yes.
We have a weird show. Weird show. All right, let's get this over here.
Drunken pig would be a really fun pet.
You say that.
That would be the most fun ever.
You say that, but you don't really know.
You'd be like, oink. Not off of it. Oink.
Oh, all right, are you ready for the nonsense?
Hi, monkey. Yes.
Start it here. I put on the right thing this week. No. Look, I did. Okay. Each week, Catherine goes out worldwide, interwebs, finds all sorts of horrible stuff. Back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Mom. And... do you remember a while back we had that story about the teenagers who kidnapped the llama and took it on the train?
Yes.
And it didn't make a damn bit of sense.
No.
Well, it's all just a case of history repeating. It gets you the story link over here. I've got so much window. Okay, well, no, you know, yeah, we'll start with the easy one. We'll start with the kind one and work our way to hell from here. All right, let's see. The kind one, I say. All right, fuck, here we go again. Fun with computer. Help computer. Everybody can already see the story, but that's okay. That's just, that happens. All right, where's the thing to...
Spoiler alert!
Well, I didn't count on... thing. I didn't count on this. I must send you the link somehow! Somehow! All right.
Well, Mike just asked me if he needed to send links to me.
Yes, I might do that. In fact, that's probably our better way of doing things. Right now, here's that. Get off the screen, because you're in our way. You're in the way of the show. You're in the way of progress, computer. You're just disappointing on so many levels. Not you. Yes. Teens accused of taking stolen goats to McDonald's.
Huh.
When I think of all the places to take a stolen goat, that's the first one that springs to mind. Overland Park,
maybe
Kansas.
What? Place what? Needed a petting zoo?
So the play place needs, you know, a fumigation with heavy, you know, anything to kill all the germs. There are so many. Five teenagers are accused of stealing a goat from a popular suburban Kansas City children's farm and taking it to a McDonald's restaurant. Kansas City Star reports the goat was stolen from Deanna Rose Children's Farmstead and spotted around 2 a.m. Sunday in a McDonald's parking lot in Olathe. They said the teens took the goat to the restaurant but were asked to leave. Officers found the goat outside when they arrived, contacted police when they learned the animal was from the farm. Okay, I know it's Kansas. I know it's the middle of fucking nowhere, right? And there's not it's not exactly the most thrill-a-minute place. But for fuck's sake, this is what you do for fun?
Imagine how confused that poor goat was.
No, actually, goat didn't give a shit.
You think they at least got him some french fries?
That goat probably was eating anything that wasn't, you know, like, nailed down. French fries is the least. Eating the french fries, eating the wrapper, eating a plastic, you know, tray, eating all of the things.
McDonald's french fries? McDonald's french fries, what's up?
Oh, yep. I don't know what's with kids these days, because, you know what? When I was that age, I had the whole idea of, what should I do for fun tonight? I'm going to steal a goat. No, it was, I'm going to attempt to get laid. What happened to that? Is that not an option for kids anymore?
Go to the movies, go to the mall, steal livestock.
You say go to the movies, go to the mall. What a guy is thinking is try to get laid. That's what those.
Yeah, but kids are getting laid at, like, 12 now, right?
Right, so it's not that difficult.
By the time they're in high school, that's old, that's boring, they're seeking new thrills.
Oh, man, sex is so over. Let's steal a farm animal!
Well, maybe the two are not entirely unconnected.
Social Mogo. Goat Simulator. You're doing it wrong. Yeah. Yeah.
Did you attack the stupid file already? You're staring at it. She's been like in the pounce pose. 10 minutes just wiggling her butt around.
Oh. Well, okay, guys. Well, Great Manning Grand Yellow says, hello. Handle them there. Well, if these guys stole a goat, don't think any girl would be into them. Yeah, you know, that's not a way to impress ladies. It really isn't. You don't go, hey, ladies, guess what I did?
Look what I got.
Farm animal.
I got a goat.
I got a goat.
I want a party. I got a goat. Hey, you know what? It worked for the rubber bandits.
Yes, but that you can actually ride a horse. I don't think you could ride a goat.
If you're really petite.
And, yeah, that goat was, of all the things, that goat's never going to be the same, though. It's always going to long for the McDonald's.
Now he is tasting french fries. Whatever they feed them at the zoo just isn't going to be enough.
It's going to long for the McDonald's.
And he's going to flip down like Bridget. Ugh, kibble. Ugh.
Well, the next story is also also Kansas and also involving an animal. And it's more, yeah, this is we're getting back into regular territory for our show. God help us all. You don't like spiders, do you?
I mean, who does? My sister is, like, mortally terrified of spiders. Like, you say the word spider and she twitches. I'm not a fan of them. If they don't bother me, I won't bother them. If they get within my personal, if they get within my personal bubble, I start getting irritated.
It sounds like your sister could be the woman in our next story. I'll send it over to Mike. Also from Kansas. And this is very fucking arachnophobia, I must say. Kansas woman says she started fire to kill spider. Woman charged with arson after duplex fire.
Nuke him from orbit. It's the only way to be sure.
34-year-old Hutchinson woman who says she lit a fire to kill a spider and charged with aggravated arson after firefighters had to put out a...
You just said lit a spider to kill a spider.
Lit a fire to kill a spider? What?
You said lit a spider to kill a spider.
Whoops. Shut up. Charged with aggravated arson after firefighters had to put out a small blaze in her half of the duplex. The woman was arrested early Friday after five Hutchinson Fire Department trucks responded to extinguish the fire. Deputy Fire Chief Doug Hannon, that's a fire his name, Doug Hannon. Firefighters found light smoke coming from the woman's half of the duplex and some clothing smoldering inside the doorway. Also found multiple points of origin for the fire, but the duplex only sustained minor smoke damage. Okay, multiple points of origin means she was chasing the spider around with flame. And you know how she did it. She had a lighter and a can of something, aerosol can of something.
So she had a cigarette lighter and was lighting up some towels.
What?
It says, a police summary of the incident says the woman told officers she used a cigarette lighter to ignite some towels to kill a spider. I don't understand that plan.
Okay, you know what?
Unless I
know
the spider was in the towels.
Was she like doing like some Ripley shit, you know? Trying to force the fucker out the airlock? Not how that works.
Maybe the spider was like in the towels?
You know, when I was a kid, I was a little pyro, and I'd be outside, and you gave me fire, and I would do some horrendous shit with it. But you know what? My excuse was, I was 12. Kids do that. They're insane.
34 is old enough to know better.
If you're 35 years old, and your first response to an insect in your home is to start a blaze, that's not exactly what we call a proportionate response.
Maybe invest in a can of Raid. Although I have to say, people do irrational things. Like, I ruin the paint job in my old kitchen because my response to bugs was to get my bottle of Clorox Cleanup and just shoot until I shot them out of the air.
But that's not it.
Which don't kill anything, but also ruin the paint. So it looked like I had this very Jackson Pollock splatter paint thing going on.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, because that's not exactly going to... It's not what we call a good kill ratio going on there. You're mostly just destroying the decor.
Hey, I killed a lot of bugs that way. I shot a bee right out of the sky. And he landed in the sink, and then I washed him down the drain.
Yeah, but you didn't resort to flame, okay? If you're, you know, back in the olden days when humanity was just crawling out of the caves and shit, all afraid of the sun, and we were needed fire indoors, I kind of get that, but it's the modern era, okay? Fire should never happen inside. Even at most, it should happen in this little stone alcove that we brick off away from everything.
Right, I was going to say, people have places.
Right, it should not be, you know, in the living room, just, you know what, fire, that's cool.
Not until we actually get to the point of The Walking Dead and society breaks down.
Society has it broken down already?
It's getting there.
So to top that level of stupidity, this one just blows my fucking mind. Even, I don't care if you're stupid or mentally disabled or whatever, this is just, how does your head do this and think this is a good plan? This comes from Memphis. Memphis Zoo visitor. Come on.
Really all animals tonight.
Memphis Zoo visitor hops barrier in a bid to feed lions cookies. At some point, okay, this plan made sense, is the thing that scares me. Memphis Zoo officials have banned a woman after... What?
Who doesn't like cookies?
Carnivores!
I bet Bridget would like cookies if we offered them to her. She certainly likes my nephew's blueberry pancakes in the morning.
Officials banned a woman after saying she climbed over a barrier to the enclosure where the lions are kept to try to feed them cookies. The identified woman's actions were reported by other zoo patrons who saw her jump the barrier and heard her singing to the animals. Barrier, only wire separates guests from the lion inside the enclosure. Singing some song and telling them how much she missed them, it was bizarre. I've never seen someone sing to a lion. It was really loud, says witness Michelle Beasley. This is what happens if you get way too into the Lion King.
I also get, I sing songs to Bridget all the time.
Yeah, but you know what? Bridget isn't going to put your whole head in her mouth.
Bridget is so cute. And then she either glares at me or like shows appreciation, depending on how good the song is that day. And really, lions are just big house cats.
No, they're not! They're apex fucking predators!
Well, yes, but if Bridget was the size of a lion, she'd be an apex predator of toy mice and bugs.
And yes, and you know what she would do? She would eat you!
Did you see the thing in Russia where the stray cat wandered into the lynx display at a zoo?
Yes, I saw.
And totally made friends with the, and the zoo had to adopt this cat because they made friends.
That was a sneaky fucking cat. Like, I'm gonna get room and board the hard way. I'm gonna cute my way into freedom.
And it's adorable.
Okay, what's just blowing my mind here is that this was a plan. She woke up in the morning and went, today is the day I feed Simba some cookies.
Maybe she baked the cookies just for the lions. Maybe they were in the shape of little gazelles. It's misguided, but sweet.
Okay, demented demon. Girl Scouts, don't fuck around.
Excuse me, Mr. Mufasa. I have your Thin Mints and your Tagalongs. Yeah.
I have to wonder what the lions thought of this. Beyond, what the fuck is this shit?
The lions were like, dinner brought dessert.
Yeah, pretty much.
But I can't make fun because this is totally going to be me someday. Someday when I'm a crazy lady with 30 cats, this is going to be me. I'm going to my reality switch is just going to flip and I'm going to be like, you know what the tigers at the zoo need? They need cookies and hugs. And I'm going to put my 30 cats in a stroller. We're all going to go to the zoo and try to give cookies to tigers and then I'll be locked up forever. That's how it's going to go down.
I blame
you with
Disney
a stroller full of kitty cats.
I blame cookies. Disney because Disney taught people that singing and jungle animals go together, and they don't. Okay, let's shift gears a little bit. I know the MRA motherfuckers have this whole thing about, man, she's just a gold digger, she appreciates. Okay, fuck that. But there are some people who are very shallow, and material goods appeal to them beyond, you know, human relationships. But in those cases, you've got to let go and move on. This, however, heart was in the right place. Head was in the worst possible place ever.
You're right. I'll totally die trying to feed cookies to the hippos.
True. It comes from China here. Hundreds of IMAX tickets purchased in man's bid to win back long lost love.
That's a bad comma.
Hundreds of Transformers
tickets. Back long, comma, lost love.
Yes. It's grammar bad.
Is he in love with a 15-foot python? Is he in love with a tomcat?
Eat, shoots, and leaves. The South China Morning Post reports a rags-to-riches man, surnamed Wang, has spent a quarter of a million, is it yen?
Yen.
Okay. Buying hundreds of tickets to IMAX screenings of the Paramount release to impress a woman who left him 7 years ago and moved to Beijing after he was unable to afford a movie date. In an effort to show an ex how successful he had become, he booked all of the seats in 4 out of the 6 IMAX theaters in China's capital city for Friday's showing of the 4th installment of the Michael Bay-directed franchise of Giant Transforming Robots from Space. He offered the tickets to WTFIWWY, that's kind of like their Twitter, WTFIWWY users in Beijing, who would share his post. They did. It went viral with over 110,000 shares.
Here's the thing, though. You bought all those tickets to Transformers 4.
Yes!
Like, you want to impress a chick, buy a bunch of tickets to a good movie.
And you know that
some dude buys out the whole showing of Captain America 2, I'm there. Okay. Transformers 4, not so much.
And dude, if this is what you have to do, to get someone to go out with you, she ain't worth it. He ain't worth it. She ain't worth it. Whoever it is, they ain't worth that shit. Don't do that to yourself. You're better than that.
I mean, I guess if you're dumping somebody because they don't have money.
Why would you want that person back once you had money? What you do is you get the money, you have the good life, and then with a new girlfriend, you can rub it in the ex's face because fuck her.
And you can just pay to have your new girlfriend get plastic surgery to look like that girl anyway.
Well, no, that's creepy. That's fucking creepy.
Or, you know, just buy a real doll. It's probably cheaper.
No, well, they're saying it's like $2,500 US money, so it's about the same cost as a real doll, I think. How much do those things cost?
No, I think those are $5,000.
Yeah. Really?
Oh, yeah.
I could buy a car!
Or you could buy a date for life.
Also, dude, your heart's in the right place, but you know what you're doing? You're encouraging Michael Bay!
You're contributing
stop
to the problem.
Stop that. Don't do that. Stop it. What are you doing?
Buy out a good movie.
Right. Go buy out How to Train Your Dragon 2. Go buy out that one. I'm cool with that.
Sure.
That was a good movie.
Buy out a Lego movie. That was pretty good.
Yes, buy out a Lego movie. Don't buy out fucking Transformers.
Buy out...
It's really...
You know, I hear Snowpiercer is good, and not just because my sweet Babu is in it.
You and Chris Evans, man, that's getting a little weird. That shit's getting a little.
He's empirically, aesthetically perfect, and he will not.
This just pisses me off so much for so many reasons. You're helping Michael Bay and trying to get back. Dude, she don't deserve you, dude. This is some romantic shit. I get that. But, dude, she don't deserve you. You deserve better. You deserve less crazy. Okay?
If you hadn't bought out those showings, you might have met a girl at one of them.
Autobots transform and fail at romance. Yeah, that's computer. He did give the ticket to the people who helped share his post, but still.
Oh, that's nice.
I know, but that'd be sort of, oh, you gave me a ticket to Transformers 4. That's sort of like when you get socks for Christmas and shit. You gotta, oh, thank you.
I don't know, man. Lindsay was really into Transformers 4. Like, I think it's her religion now.
There but for the grace of God go I, is all I can say about that. There but for the grace of God. Okay. You mentioned real dolls earlier. This, again, also from China, and this just... I understand sperm banks serve an important purpose. You know, people try to have kids, they need a little help, or they just want to have a kid by themselves, need a little, you know, assistance. This is just making it weird, guys. You're fucking making it weird. You're making it weird. Automatic sperm extractor introduced into a Chinese hospital.
Oh my God, look at that thing.
That was my thoughts as well. Yes.
It's like a milking machine.
Yes!
Features a massage pipe that can be adjusted to suit the height of the user. A massage pipe.
All a gentleman has to do is plug in the frequency, amplitude, and temperature, and off they go. It's also fitted with a small screen for those feeling uninspired. You know, we're laughing, but this is going to be the internet in 10 years.
It already is. I tweeted it. They came out with the fleshlight attachment for the iPad.
The iPod, yeah.
Yeah. You can now fuck your iPad. And one of the reviews on it was like, oh my God, this makes point of view porn so much better. It's like, I'm really fucking my favorite porn star. And it's like, buddy, no, it's not.
No, it really isn't.
Because your iPad doesn't have tits.
Also, probably your Also, your favorite porn star probably doesn't have plastic handles on the side.
That probably you'd like to hope. But I mean, man, every day we're a little more living in a William Gibson novel.
This is just fucked. Look at that
Who
thing.
Thought he would be the great prophet of our times? William Gibson.
William Gibson, yeah.
Like, all of his books are someday just going to be collected as scripture. And it will be the Gibson Gospel, because he saw it all coming.
Actually, you know, if you go back and read, like, Neuromancer, it's kind of hilarious, because they started talks about, like, gigabytes and like, they're the biggest fucking thing ever, and cassette tapes and discs and everything, and you're like, oh, bless your heart.
But, like, Idoru, there's actually an Idoru in Japan now, a pop star that's totally virtual.
Yeah.
I mean, half the stuff in pattern recognition has come true. Like pattern recognition is all about this mysterious footage that they're trying to find the source of. And what was that YouTube thing everybody was talking about a couple weeks ago, that mysterious YouTube channel that was just colors and shapes? Like, he's like our Nostradamus.
This is just, I mean, there's not, can you imagine going into a little room and there's nothing in there? But big lights overhead, and it's all white. There's this thing sitting in the middle of it.
And, like, a porny R2-D2. Go ahead and watch Star Wars. Try not to think about that now.
You came in that thing? You're braver than I thought. Just someone saw this as a need. And really, guys, I'm going to tell you, they don't take this much work to get going. If they do, they have other issues.
It's gonna.
But if you need like a droid to get to where you're going, see your doctor. See your doctor.
It's just how do they clean it?
Hopefully with a hose and protective gear and standing back at a good long distance.
No, like that has internal, like.
I'd just spray the fucker down with disinfectant and pray if that were me, but. Finally, our last story tonight, we are back in our regular territory. This hasn't happened in a while, and I was kind of, you know, thinking maybe this was over, but no. In fact, this one's got a nice little twist to it.
It's never over.
They got me thinking of Phantasm.
I was thinking of Daft Punk.
Naked stranger floods family's kitchen and defecates on floor.
Okay.
Like you do
on a Tuesday.
Kuna, Idaho. A family is still reeling after a naked stranger entered their home last weekend. They say he flooded their kitchen, defecated on the carpet, and here's the twist, but was not arrested. Patricia Gillespie and her husband moved in their home just last week, but right now a massive cleanup effort is underway after woke up 6:30 Sunday morning, you never want to be awake at 6:30 a.m. on Sunday, to see a naked guy walking into our bedroom. Husband's like, what the heck is going on? And I'm screaming in utter panic. Intruder, who police say was 25-year-old Matthew Coombs, had been drinking. Surprise. After surprising the couple, they say he ran into another bedroom and put his shorts on. My husband grabbed the gun because we have no idea who this guy is. He's like, get out of my house now. But the guy would leave.
So he had clothes with him?
Yeah, apparently, but he got naked there. He made himself at home a bit. But I love this. When you have a gun on you and someone says to leave, the correct answer is not no. That is the wrong answer.
Generally, yes. Yes.
The answer
yes.
You're looking for is yes, sir.
You know, at that point, I don't think words can do anything more than just turning around and leaving could do.
Coombs left the home and not the property, and as police arrived, the family found what police say Coombs had done to their before he came into their bedroom. He took the sink sprayer out the drawer, and it was in there. He put it in the drawer, turned it on full blast hot water, filled the entire drawer full. It flooded my entire kitchen. He craps on the floor. He must have been playing in it because he streaked it down the sides of my walls. Upsetting as that was, Trisha said she was more upset by the fact that Coombs was cited with two misdemeanors, but was not arrested by the responding officer. Have we reached the point where this is just kind of okay now?
This is just a thing that happens to you sometimes?
It's gotten to be so common, the cop's just like, oh, just write him a ticket and move on. We got three more naked guys to deal with today.
Well, you know, the best way to stop a bad guy with poop is a good guy. How is this something that gets you put in jail? First of all, it's breaking and entering.
Exactly. It's not like they invited him in. It's like, come in, random stranger. Poop on our floor. Flood our kitchen. Enjoy yourself. It's Sunday.
I don't understand how this isn't crime. What kind of laws do they have in Idaho?
Oh, this is crime.
That's a statement. This is crime.
Apparently now in America, it is okay walking to another stranger's, to a complete stranger's home, shit on the floor, fuck with their kitchen, go naked into their bedroom, and you get a ticket.
You should give that a try when you're back in the States.
No!
Fuck that should be your next episode.
Fuck no. We'll probably talk Brad into it, though. He'd do it. Like, hey, Brad. Go shit in that person's kitchen and get naked. Will do.
Okay.
Okay. Mother of God. This is not what you want to deal with first thing on a Sunday morning. Sunday morning, 6:30 a.m.
What was I doing yesterday at Sunday at 6:30 a.m.? I was curled up with the cat sleeping, and I was very happy.
Right, because you know what you have to do. Either two things happen. Either you got to go back to work Monday, or later that morning, you got to go to church. And if you go to church after naked pooping guy has been in your house, God doesn't want to hear about it.
He's like, look, I got wars, pestilence, I'm busy. The sad part is God said they had just moved into that house. This is your
bad insurance. I guess the first thing we learned this week is that the definition of crime has radically shifted. Maybe it's our fault. Maybe it's our show that caused that. Maybe it's our fault.
I'm not owning that.
We've just made it so commonplace that the cops are just like, oh yeah, that happens all the time.
That makes us villains on par with the Supreme Court of the United States, and I am not wearing that. Absolutely not.
If the robe fits. We learned that, you know, there are many things you can do to impress a woman, but Michael Bay is not one of them.
And if it is,
you don't want that.
Maybe don't cruise for dates on lowered expectations.
Yeah, you don't want that. You just don't want that. That's no good is going to come of that.
It's 3 miles of bad road.
We learned that, yes, you can fuck it. That's the entire point.
Welcome to the future.
We have, you know, it's of all the things to dedicate our research and development dollars for, the Sperm Sucker 3000 is not the one. Oh my God. We also learned that goats don't belong at McDonald's.
At least not live ones.
Yeah, don't ask what's in Big Mac. No. Oh, you still there, Tara? Oh, weird shit's happening with Tara. Tara? What's happening? Are you there?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Hi.
Hello?
God?
There you are. Now you're back. What the hell happened?
I did a you can't do that on television joke, and I broke the internet.
You just kind of froze and glitched out.
You froze on a very disapproving face, so for a minute, I thought you just really hated my you can't do that on television joke. And then I realized that wasn't it.
We've learned that if you must kill some sort of insect in your home, fire bad.
Yes.
Fire bad.
Proportionate response.
And finally this week, we learned, you know, there's crazy cat lady, and then there's taking it one step beyond.
I'll be the crazy cat lady trying to feed the hippos cookies.
You see, the hippos would eat the cookies because they're omnivores. Aren't they?
No.
They're herbivores? I must have upset Tara because she... Oh, God, that is a horrible face to freeze on.